cheap designer sunglasses.
You sure that's him?
I'm reading his rank and name tag.
He's moving.
650. Range me.
Range correct, 650.
When he clears the civilians, he's mine.
If you want to own your enemies, then you're going to have to become a master of estimating the range to target. There are three basic ways to judge distance to target. The first type is visual estimation. This is probably the most important because you'll be using it all the time. In order to estimate range visually, we first need to know what our target looks like at different ranges. The following screenshots show the relationship between crosshairs and target size at 50 meter intervals. For the first 150 meters, the target size shrinks rapidly. 150 meters is also the distance when we need to start compensating for bullet drop by aiming above our target. The next few clips are shots from less than 150 meters. Therefore, I'm aiming straight at their head to get the kill. Notice on this 150 meter shot that I no longer aim at the center of the head. Instead, I start to aim at the top of their head. Aiming high is required beyond this range because bullet drop does exist in the game, and you cannot adjust your sights for it. At 200 meters, you need to start aiming high, so just leave a small gap of 1 to 3 pixels. At 300 meters, the gap needs to be increased to approximately 3 to 5 pixels. By the time you get out to 400 meters, you're going to have to aim well above the target. Leave a gap of approximately 5 to 8 pixels. Now, these guidelines are based on the L96A1. However, all other sniper rifles have similar bullet drop characteristics. The M95 has the largest amount of bullet drop, so you have to aim extra high. Now, judging distance visually takes a lot of time and practice to get good at, so we need something to help you out in the meantime. Your best source of distance information is the flags at spawn points. Your distance to the flag will always be shown underneath the flag icon. Now, your target is not always going to be standing right next to the flag, so the value shown can only be used as a rough estimate. So if you want to know a more precise measurement of the distance to your target, here's what you do. Make your own squad so that you have the squad leader capabilities. Using the attack marker, you can now find the ranges to different areas of the map. You can also set the marker by looking through your scope. The distance to your marker is now shown underneath the little sword, which can be placed anywhere on the map. This makes it very easy to check the range to target before you even shoot. On the ground. 400 meters is usually the longest range that you can see a human target. That being said, there are rare occasions when you can actually see targets beyond 400 meters. The following is a staged setup. My target, who is near this flag, is still visible at over 500 meters. If you can see it, You can kill it. Here's another shot at just under 500 meters. Your bullet travels well beyond what you can see. So if you blindly take pot shots, you may actually hit something. There is, however, a better way to hit things beyond draw distance. The ultimate in long-range shooting requires the use of a spotter. Here's how you set up an extremely long-range shot. The first thing you need is a squad leader who is a really good spotter. He needs to place the marker right between the feet of your target. Although it starts to disappear, your squad leader's marker is visible for over 1,000 meters. Here you can see my range to target is 941 meters. At extremely long ranges, your target is approximately the size of the blade of the marker sword. Using the M95, you need to aim at the hilt of the sword if your target is standing, or aim at the tip of the sword if your target is lying prone. The range to my next target is 918 meters. My target is also standing, so I will aim at the hilt of the sword. So now that we know how to set up this shot, let's go try this technique in a live server. In this first clip, I am spotting for my squad member, Gump Buster.
Aim right on the sword.
He is shooting from the aircraft carrier, which is over 560 meters to the target.
No way.
Having a good spotter is the key to making these shots work. You will see his first shot impact on the pipe above the sniper. I then instruct him to aim one pixel down and one pixel to the right.
Get him.
This shot was taken at over 600 meters. So with Gump Buster spotting, it's now my turn to shoot. Here's a look at the map for the setup of this shot. The range to this target is 670 meters. My spotter for the next shot is Swedish Hunter. I'm shooting from the top deck of the aircraft carrier, while Swedish Hunter is spotting from the artillery island. Range to target is 794 meters. Now these shots are not easy, so I'm going to reshow the entire clip. You'll notice that it takes 3 attempts to make this shot work.
Good job.